Kampala High Court Judge Margaret Mutoni has today delivered her ruling in a case where a one Abubakar Kalungi was accused of murdering former police commander Muhammad Chirumira and his female friend Reste Mbabazi Nalinya in September 2018. The trial judge acquitted Abubakar Kalungi. While giving her judgment, she faulted the prosecution team for not doing enough to prove that the accused person indeed participated in this double murder.
Led the investigation in this case, killed it the moment the focus was on the ADF operatives, yet no evidence was adduced before court linking the accused with ADF. I agree with the opinion of the two lead assessors that the accused should be acquitted, and I hereby acquit him of the two counts of murder. Should be released unless held over some other charges. The prosecution is free to appeal against this decision if it is not satisfied.
She noted that a charge and caution statement in which the accused reportedly confessed to the murder of Chirumira was recorded in English and not the Luganda language best understood by the suspect.
Charge and caution statement is read back to the suspect through a translator in the language he or she understands, and or he or she signs the English version. In this case, a translator was not necessary because the recording police officer was well versed with the local language of the appellant.
The judge further observed that the author of the statement, Walimbwa, was not only incompetent but lied about the suspect's state of health.
Courts of law do not make assumptions on anything as the law is applied to facts before it. In the instant case, he was arrested, detained, tortured and charged before getting any circumstantial evidence connecting him with a crime that would corroborate with any other evidence.
She further noted that even the witness presented in court only furnished court with lies and fictitious information instead of telling the truth, an indication that prosecution didn't fully investigate the murder, rather it depended on hearsay.
I thank Allah that finally my husband has been set free after so long. My brother has finally been set free after 4 years of battling false charges. It is painful that for all these years he has been prosecuted for nothing. I thank Allah for such a miracle. This is a miracle indeed. It is not because we had a lot of money or good lawyers, but because of Allah, our relative has been set free.
Court started the trial of Hamza Mwebe and Abubakar Kalungi in connection to the murder last year. However, Mwebe was acquitted by the Lady Justice in December 2022 after prosecution failed to prove their case against him due to lack of evidence. Kalungi was left to defend himself. 15 prosecution witnesses and several exhibits were produced in court as prosecution strived to pin Kalungi. Still in court, Fabrice Brad Rulinda has been confirmed as the duly elected mayor of Entebbe Municipality after the High Court in Kampala dismissed a petition challenging his election victory. The petition filed by Rulinda's rival and also former mayor of Entebbe, Kayanja DePaul of Democratic Party, sought nullification of Rulinda's election, citing falsification of entries on declaration of result forms. The court ruling, read by the Deputy Registrar Jamson Kalemani of the High Court, dismissed Kayanja's petition and maintained Rulinda as the duly elected mayor for Entebbe Municipality.
Well, I am happy. I'm excited that the law has actually prevailed. The first judge did tell them exactly the same thing, that there is no merit to their case. They insisted they wanted to be heard. I'm glad that the courts of law accepted for them to be heard. They were heard and the results are still the same. This is something they lost, and let us focus on the development of Entebbe.
Meanwhile, the same court confirmed Muhammad Nsereko as the duly elected Kampala Central MP. Justice Jesse Byaruhanga Rujema delivered the verdict today in his ruling on election petition filed by the National Unity Platform candidate Fred Nyanzi Sentamu on the grounds of lack of evidence to sustain the alleged electoral offences during the January 14, 2021 elections. In the ruling delivered by the Deputy Registrar Jameson Kalemani, court found that the evidence of some of the witnesses Nyanzi assembled, such as Hamza Lubega, were self-confessed criminals who admitted to committing many crimes, including murder, as long as they could be paid.
They're not done in anyone's favor. It was the will of the people of Kampala.
We shall continue to do our work as legislators. Nothing shall deter us. We thank our voters, we thank our supporters, we thank our people. But to our countrymen outside there, the expectations you have in us is service delivered. For the people who pay taxes in Kampala, not to see potholes.
Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.